A new outfit. And a weapon like Artok's. I guess the chieftain gets the chieftain's gear. And now it's a long notch. Nothing left to see from Peter's drum. Stocking up. That'll keep my stomach quiet. Mm-hmm. before I even breathe out. That'll help. Survive. Hardy little plant. You'll help.
Long Notch is well stocked, as you asked.
And our scouts are watching for more Frost Claws.
Our numbers rise. 3 more hunters have passed their trials.
But our purpose was to take back the mountain. Now what?
Stay prepared. Sharpen your spears. Should we not return, defending the cut falls to you. If our chieftain agrees with his course.
Sounds like good advice, but let's hope it doesn't come to that.
Chieftain?
The weight of command is no small burden.
I can see that. I take it you haven't spoken to Araya yet?
Why should I? This is what she wanted, to return to Thunder's Drum. It is her only care. So I should have known she would find a way to push aside my spear. After the Karja took my sister, not all of her came back.
What happened to Araya when she was a captive of the Karja?
As a shaman, she's adept with machines, tracking them, stunning them. The Karja used her to capture them for the Sunring, where they were unleashed upon the innocent. They made her part of their blood sport. The shame she suffered beneath their pitiless sun.
She survived.
She endured. Endured by reminding herself of the spirit, her purpose. And now that's all she has.
Tell me what happened to the first expedition.
Araya led the way to the summit, but it was blocked by a great door, some kind of cauldron, new metal. We tried to break through, but it was unflinching. We were exhausted, no way forward and machines behind. I made the call to push back. It cost us greatly. But to remain would have cost us everything. I had hoped to never subject Araya to that again.
What do you think is beyond that door?
I do not know. That expanse of metal, that dead hum. Nothing sacred belongs there. Machines and death, that's what the mountain holds. Death for us or for the daemon.
And if we do find the spirit,
then perhaps we should put it out of its misery.
For what it's worth, I'm glad you're coming with me.
Someone has to keep Araya safe.
Foolish young hunters. They speak of the claws beneath.
Aloy, this is it. My chance to reunite with the spirit, and perhaps to reunite her with the blue light. It's not a chance I would have had alone. I needed an outsider. Someone ignorant of our ways, but no, not ignorant.
Are you trying to thank me, Araya?
Yes, of course. That's what you do. Untangle knots. Create possibilities. Thank you for making this pilgrimage possible. I only wish it had not been necessary to humiliate Aratak. You were wise to let him come. He's earned the right. Stubborn as stone, but he's had to be. The war demanded it. And so have I.
Aratak told me you were a captive of the Karja for a long time. It sounded bad.
For Aratak, it all comes back to that. He thinks the Karja changed me. They did not. They merely sharpened my focus. When all else is lost, you think about what's truly important. The spirit. The blue light. The beyond. And my brother, too. Every time I felt the chill northern wind, I thought of him, worried for him.
What did the war do to Aratak?
He cut away everything until only his true self remained. Unyielding ice. Nobunuk has more sheer will. He fought the Karja for 1,000 freezing nights, yet always rallied his hunters at sunrise. It is said he endured 23 wounds in those years. His hunters counted them. He never complains of one. Instead, he complains that life with me is harder. He's right. What have I ever given him but struggle?
Now that I'm chieftain of the Werak, I don't suppose I can order you to tell me about Silence?
Aratak would never have presumed to grasp for a secret of the Conclave. But you are not Aratak, and if you have dealt with Silence, your need is well apparent. Silence came to Bon Or from the distant north, a young shaman of the Owl's Watch, a remote Werak that rarely comes south to parley.
Silence was a shaman.
He was. Or at least, when we sent runners to ask the Owl's Watch, they said he was. His knowledge of the machines was beyond compare, and he was hungry to trade what he knew to the rest of us. It didn't take him long to gain the trust of the Conclave, and eventually, an invitation to attend.
What about you? Did you trust him?
No. But he impressed me. He carried himself with poise and authority. I wanted to learn from him, but that was not to be. He was granted knowledge of our most sacred meeting place, the frozen caves of the Malmstrom, a month's march from Bon Or. He met with us there, as is custom at high winter. But when we next returned, the caves had been looted. Relics of the old world stolen, holes cut in ice and metal.
Yeah, that'd be Silence, all right.
He vanished with the spoils. We sent our best trackers after him. None returned. And when we checked back with the Owl's Watch, those who had vouched for him were gone, as though he never existed. Some in the Conclave began to doubt he was even Banuk to begin with.
And what do you think?
He committed an unforgivable sacrilege. He's unscrupulous and dangerous, but also brilliant, skilled, and knowledgeable without equal. Except, perhaps, for you. Anyone else I would warn off, but you may be able to treat with him safely. Just don't lower your guard.
I'll keep that in mind, Horea. Thanks. What are we gonna find up there, Horea?
Ruins. Machines. And a door, like that of a cauldron. I have faith that you can find a way through it, Aloy. For beyond it lies the spirit. I know I can find her there. Though I do not doubt the daemon has tried to hide the way.
It hasn't been easy for you, Aurea. Getting back to this point.
It was all to hear her voice again. This time, we both will.
I'd like that.
Are you ready then? Once we ascend, it will be hard to turn back. Finally, we ascend.
How? I don't see a way up.
Not up. Through.
No, brother!
Thank you.
see.
Please remain calm.
I too can call upon the power of the old ones. What was this place?
The spirit once told me that this all used to be part of its domain. A fortress that defended humankind from terrible danger.
Fortress? Looks more like a machine.
Is that not fitting? Blue light often dwells in machines.
Let's just hope that some remains here. Metal pillars. Taller than yours, cliffs. I still don't like it. Here, up and over.
The drop on them.
Last we were here, we fought our way through there. But machines overcame us. We retreated, dropping supplies and taking losses. Now we must prevail, with only two warriors and a shaman to protect.
Aloy is no ordinary warrior. And I can hold my own. And so, we could go that way instead. There are machines up there, but also cover. We could stay hidden, at least for a while.
All right, I get the options. Now follow my lead. Steam, frost. What was all this for? Need them soon enough.
whatever supplies were left.
Yes! This might even the odds.
It was the spirit. The old ones. I could only grasp some of what they said.
You were right, Aurea. This place was built to stop something terrible. And it worked. As for the spirit, I'm starting to get an idea of what it could be.
The door is open now. We can get through.
Machines to get to that door.
Aloy will see us through.
Onward. Our challenge awaits. I have a score to settle with them.
Gotta be. Chance with me.
Machines. Make ready.
Years have passed since I stood here. Since then, the daemon has taken over.
It's like an infection. Attacking all this machinery.
Everything has changed. It's twisted. The path I took to get to the spirits lost to us.
Find a new path, Araya. I promise. All right. Let's go.
Yes. And finish this.